Hi, let us understand about role-based access control. For understanding purpose, let's assume we do not have any roles and directly we are going to attach some policies to the user. Let's assume there are n number of users and I'm going to create n number of policies. I can attach the policy directly to the user. Yes, it's going to work fine, but there's going to be a problem whenever there is a change in the access control in terms of the policies or for certain users. Say in this particular example, this group of users is going to have two policies. Now, within that, I'm going to have another project, say different type of policy needs to be created and attach that to two different users. All I need to do is I have to change both this particular user details and attach this particular new policy. And let's assume that is for a new project and that particular project got over and I need to change or remove this particular policy from these two users. In that case, I will end up changing for both these users, and in real-time scenario, we will end up making this particular change for huge number of users, and that's going to trigger huge number of changes into n number of users, and every user I need to manage it individually. And that's where role-based access control comes into picture, where I'm going to have some sort of a virtual middle layer called a role, and I can create a role and add the permissions to the role, and I can map n number of policies to the role, and users can be made to play any such role in case if that particular user is not part of that particular project. All I need to do is remove that particular mapping to the role or remove the policy to the role so that all the users attached to that particular role will not have that particular permission. So this particular third layer, what we are going to add is going to create flexibility in terms of managing the policies getting attached or removing from the user, as well as I can make changes to a group of users in a single change. The same way, like how I am attaching a role to the user, I can make the role to get attached to a token, or directly I can attach the policy to a token. Token is nothing but it's an authentication token saying this particular user is authenticated into this particular device. And the similar way, I can attach any policy directly to the user as well. Generally, we will be avoiding the process of attaching the policy directly to the user, and it is not recommended, but it can be done. For a small project or for test purpose, we can do that. We will be trying out all these different scenarios for our demo purpose. First, we will be understanding how this role-based access control authentication authorization going to work. Then we will move on to different type of authentication, different type of tokens, different type of role-based access control setup within HashiCorp Vault.